Hi, this is Tony DiMeo, and today we're going to discuss my book, Common Sense Rules for Everyday Leaders. It's a unique view of leadership and one I think you'll enjoy. Definition of leadership. The position or function of a leader is a person who guides or directs a group that he manages to maintain despite heavy opposition. Everyone is a leader. Everyone is leading somebody. Parents may be the most important leaders of all. No title is necessary to become a leader or to be a leader. As a matter of fact, some of the greatest leaders have had no titles. Everyone has the ability to add value to any situation. Lead by deed. The greatest of all leadership is one that leads by example. That's the real great leaders lead by example. The first person to lead is yourself. Before you can lead anyone else, you have to lead yourself. Lead by deed. Be the example. What you do speaks a lot louder than what you say. Walk the walk, not just talk the talk. Actions speak louder than words. It's hard to respect a leader who leads by the practice of do what I say, not what I do. Everybody has heard that from their parents at one time or another. Practice what you preach. Very good advice. The lead by deed rule. Leadership by example speaks the loudest. Always lead from the front. It's easier to pull people with you than it is to push. Lead by deed. Leaders who are the most effective are those that lead by deed. Leaders who lead by example are never misunderstood. You have to be before you can do. Here are some easy tips. Setting the example eliminates the need for 6-inch thick policy manuals. The better the example, the smaller the policy manual. Be the person you want others to become. Decide what's important and make sure you embody those things. This is one of my favorite poems on leadership. It's called Show Me the Sermon. I'd rather see a sermon than hear one any day. I'd rather you walk with me than merely point the way. The eye is a better listener than ever was the ear. Advice can be confusing, but example is always clear. Think big. The second area of leadership is to think big. Aspire to big goals. Big dreams attract big people. We're going to talk about the Michelangelo rule in a minute. Dream big, but step small. Have a big vision, but don't overlook details. Raise standards, change beliefs, and change strategy. The Michelangelo rule. The greatest danger for most of us lies not in setting our aim too high and falling short, but in setting our aim too low and achieving our mark. By the famous master Michelangelo. Success is never an accident. No one scaled Mount Everest while going out for a nice walk. Tom Brady didn't go from a 6th-round draft pick to a Super Bowl star by accident. Derek Jeter hit 202 and made 55 errors in the minors before he became a Major League superstar. Some tips from the master. Mastery doesn't happen overnight. Trifles make perfection, and perfection is no trifle. Michelangelo. Chase perfection, and you might catch excellence. Lessons from fiction. Overlooked source of lessons. One of my favorite Shakespeare's plays is Henry IV, and that's famous for the speech at the Battle of Agincourt. It's a great inspirational fictional piece that is good for any team. The Wizard of Oz rule is one of my favorites. Oz never gave nothing to the Tin Man. Did he? Was the Wizard a leader? Was the Wizard of Oz a leader or just a con man behind a flimsy curtain with a lot of smoke and mirrors? Did the little old man really provide anything for Dorothy, the Scarecrow, the Tin Man, or the Cowardly Lion? A dealer in hope. Leaders give people hope. The Wizard gave people hope. Leaders create a way for their followers to reach their potential. The Wizard provided for the Lion, the Tin Man, and the Scarecrow exactly what they needed. Belief. Here's some tips from Oz. Believe in those you lead. If you don't believe in them, they won't believe in themselves. Know that certain people have certain talents, but everyone has value. And everyone can add value to a team. Here's some more tips from the Wizard. Teams get confident by working hard. Belief gets stronger when players see improvement and understand the plan. The more detailed the plan, the greater the credibility. Have a system to measure improvement. Praise pays. Sincere, specific praise builds confidence. Let people know when they are doing it right. Final tips from Oz. Never take credit for a transformation. Everyone has God-given talent and ability before ever meeting you, and they put in the work. All you did was open a door or provide a stage. All wizards get exposed when they try to claim credit. So maybe the old wizard was a leader after all. The power of synergy. Never, ever, ever underestimate the power of synergy. The team comes first. Together, everyone achieves more. 1 + 1 = 3. That's really what synergy is. Synergy, the total is greater than the sum of the individual parts. The strength of the wolf. The law of the jungle. The title of this chapter comes from Rudyard Kipling's famous poem, The Law of the Jungle. Every leader must develop a team if he is to be truly effective. He has to develop a we, not me attitude. Because there's no denying the power of teamwork. Again, one of my favorite poems goes like this. This is the law of the jungle. It's as true as the blue of the sky. The wolf that follows it shall prosper. The wolf that doesn't shall die. Just as the vine goes around the tree forward and back, the strength of the pack is the wolf, and the strength of the wolf is the pack. Rudyard Kipling. The Rotten Pumpkin Rule. You can't carve a rotten pumpkin. By Michelle DeMeo at age 4, 1992. Part of building a team is having the right people on the team. And sometimes You can have the wrong person on the team. And in that case, you have to weed that bad part of your team out. The story behind the pumpkin rule. In 1992, my daughter Michelle was 4 years old and very excited about Halloween. So I went to the farmer's market and bought two large pumpkins that I was going to carve into jack-o'-lanterns. However, it rained and a puddle spoiled the bottom of the pumpkin. I told Michelle I'd carve the pumpkins regardless, and her reply was, "Dad, you can't carve a rotten pumpkin." Lesson learned. Tips from a pumpkin. Recruit only quality people to be in your organization. My main rule of recruiting is recruit character, not characters. You must get rid of rotten pumpkins so the rot doesn't spread to others. To have a great team, get team players. Team players will sacrifice their own ambitions to be part of the team. The lesson. The lesson is obvious. You have to start with something good before you can develop it into something great. You can develop someone's technique, their sales presentation, or their product, but their core values and character are not likely to change. Concluding thoughts. Leaders are made, they are not born. They are made from hard effort, which is the price which all of us must pay to achieve any goal that is worthwhile. The great Vince Lombardi. The next step is to buy the complete book, Common Sense Rules for Everyday Leaders. It's available on my website, tonydimeo.com. I hope you've enjoyed this brief seminar, webinar. And as I said, I think you'll really enjoy this book. It's full of helpful rules and some advice that I picked up along the way. Take care. Have a great day. And thanks for listening.